Hello, hi. From Disney Springs. So today we are here to potentially have some drinks and or snacks and to go on a Christmas tree scavenger hunt. Don't really know anything about it, but I've heard that there is one and I love scavenger hunts. So that is what we're gonna do today. We're gonna go through security here in just a second, through the temperature check, and then I think start off at the World of Coke?
Yes.
The Coke store?
Yes.
For some reason I confused the World of Disney and the Coca-Cola store, but we are going to the Coca-Cola store, which is right over here, to get a beverage that we saw online that looks very promising and very good. There's a Christmas tree right here, so that's kind of neat. I don't know exactly where we're going to be starting the scavenger hunt, but hopefully somewhere and soon. Okay, so we are heading up to the rooftop bar, and do you remember the beverage you were looking at?
Coca-Cola with gingerbread flavored syrup in it. So it's just like a gingerbread Coke.
Sounds interesting. We have not eaten at Chicken Guy in a while, so we should probably rectify that at some point. We haven't made it off to Disney Springs in a little bit, so I'm very happy that we're here today. This is gonna be a pretty quick trip, but hopefully we can accomplish all that we came here to accomplish. All right, so we made it to the top of the Coca-Cola store, and we have our drinks here, which are pretty similar, but then a little bit different than each other, and I think Brennan paid a little bit more attention to what's actually in these. Brennan, take it away.
I got the non-alcoholic, which is just like gingerbread syrup in a Coca-Cola, and then you got the alcoholic one, which is like a float, like a root beer float, but with Coke, Kahlua, and Bacardi.
And we took a couple gingerbread cookies in them as well, so this is exciting. I'm very excited for this. I love myself a good float. There's the orange garage right behind you.
Oh, wow. That's really good.
Really?
Oh, it has that like ginger snap flavor. I like this a lot.
That's awesome.
So this is starting to melt a little bit. My gingerbread man is already sinking down in there. That definitely has a kick in it, but this is good. Is yours, do you like yours a lot?
I like mine a lot. Mm. It's really smooth.
I am staring into the sun, but it is worth it. This was a great idea.
Try mine.
Okay. I like that a little bit more, I think.
Okay, so I think our next stop is actually gonna be right over here, right behind Brennan's bun, to get a snack.
You're standing behind me.
I'm sorry, so I think Brennan's drink was definitely the winner here, but mine was still pretty good. But we still get a very, very cool view of Disney Springs from here. Hey, there's a rainbow over there. Isn't that pleasant? That's where we just were, right up there on top of the Coca-Cola store. And I don't know the name of the place, but we're heading right over here to grab a snack because I think Brennan, I think they had a little teriyaki bao bun. I believe that she had her eye on for a while, so let's see if that's what she ends up getting. Okay, so this is across from Wetzel's Pretzels and Haagen-Dazs. This is Yasaki by Mitsukoshi. And they have a few different drinks here. And then I think Brennan ended up making her own poke bowl, but they did have karage, Japanese-style fried chicken. They have chicken buns with sweet teriyaki sauce and then taiyaki sweet red bean stuffed pastries. A lot of very good foods here, so I think. So yeah, Brennan got her own poke bowl, and then I got this. So let's see how those taste. So Brennan's back over there waiting for the order, and I wanted to come over here because they did socially distance the Christmas tree trail this year. So instead of it being a designated trail that would probably attract a good amount of crowds, they dispersed the trees amongst Disney Springs. I know that there's a scavenger hunt that I think consists of 12 trees, but I don't know exactly where that starts because I think I actually have to get a little map, or like a scavenger hunt paper, I suppose, to actually start the scavenger hunts and then redeem it. Right here is Enzo's Hideaway Tunnel Bar and Restaurant, and that is where myself, Kylie, and Kenneth came. I didn't record it just because I wanted to spend time with them, but I had never been there before, and I finally got to go there, so I'm gonna have to go back with Brennan one of these days because that was a really, really cool and unique experience. But I think Brennan, yep, she's all the way over there now. Okay, she's got our food. Hi.
Hi.
Got your poke bowl?
I did.
Well,
and
that's cool.
Chicken.
Oh boy. So I got teriyaki glaze on this. Oh, not a glaze. It's a little side of teriyaki.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, neat. I'm kind of jealous. That looks incredible. That was what, $10?
Yeah.
Okay, and this was about $5, maybe a little bit more. Okay, so we're all done with our snacks, and now we're starting our Christmas tree scavenger hunt, but we need to find out where to start. So we're just gonna head down.
Scavenger hunt is finding the map.
Exactly, but I think we're gonna head down over here in this direction. What's that? One of the maps? We're gonna head over here to see if we can find a starting point. It is very windy, and it's probably gonna storm pretty bad here pretty soon. Okay, so we have a map. We just happened to walk into the Marvel store over here in the west end of Disney Springs, and they just happened to have the maps there, so I don't know exactly where you can get this, but I'm presuming that they're just at the cash registers of a good amount of stores. So this is the inside of the Christmas Tree Stroll 2020. Looks like there are 12 trees to find all around.
They start from pretty much House of Blues and then go up until like the Zara store, which is kind of near Blaze Pizza.
Right. Okay, so let's head all the way down to House of Blues over by Cirque du Soleil and let's start the scavenger hunt.
Let's go.
Okay, so we made it down to the House of Blues and it looks like this is our first Christmas tree, I'm pretty positive.
Mm-hmm.
Is that this one?
I think so. I hope so.
I certainly hope so. So this one is going to be, I assume, the Walt Disney World Resort tree because it has all of the different Disney parks on it. Okay, so let's go and take off that sticker in the bottom right corner. Let's put it on. Okay, so we came around the side of House of Blues just to make sure because a lot of these are in very close proximity. And I'm presuming that one was the first one. So we wanted to make sure by coming around the side back here, but we did not see any tree over here. So I'm gonna go ahead and say that the first one is gonna be that one. And let's go ahead and put it right here and then backtrack a little bit.
Are you gonna hold it?
Yes.
Okay.
We're by Cirque du Soleil currently. There you go.
It's too windy for this.
Okay, I think that we're good because we're across from House of Blues. Here's our next tree, which is the Haunted Mansion tree. This is very spooky. You know what? It's actually really nice to see these so up close with a minimal amount of people around us. So let's see. Haunted Mansion. Right there. Would you like to do the honors?
Yes.
Okay. Is this covering up trees?
No.
In this area?
Oh,
oh it is. Okay.
Oh, no.
So we do have to go all the way over here.
Oh, no.
We can do it. This is gonna be easy. And there it is, the Haunted Mansion. All right, let's keep on moving. This is exciting.
We're drawing a crowd.
And windy. This is our next tree right across from the AMC and Splitsville. And this is where Kenneth and Kylie and I had some drinks a couple weeks ago, in addition to Enzo's. And this is the Frozen tree. And Brennan's gonna go and stick that on there on the map. Here's a better look at the tree itself. It's nice to see it while it's still light outside. They're all very pretty at night, obviously, but it's cool to see some of the detail during the day. Okay, off to the next tree. Okay, we found the next tree. This is the Lion King tree. A little bit backlit up there. Let's see if I zoom in, if it'll brighten up a little bit. There we go. This is a beautiful tree, and this is pretty much across from where we actually got the map, which is, can I do it?
Yeah.
Neat. Yeah, so again, I'm not exactly sure where you can get these maps, but that's where we got it right there, the Marvel store. Okay, and here's our next tree, the Fantasia tree. Oh yeah? I like the Sorcerer Mickey hat way up on top, up there.
Mm.
All right, that's probably, which one is it? Is it this one? Is it just the generic tree?
I would think so.
I'm confused.
Hmm.
Well, let's keep it moving. Where would this one be? This one's this one right here,
I think
right?
It's this one.
Yeah, okay, so it's definitely on the map.
Yeah.
So it'll probably be that one.
Okay.
Okay, this is interesting. It says, dear guest, for the Fantasia Christmas tree, please place the sticker of Baloo on your map. So that's what it is. Okay, so.
Okay.
That could have been an unfortunate situation, so go ahead and put that one on there. We'll move on to the next one.
All right.
Okay, there's Baloo right there.
Woo-hoo.
Perfect, and now we're moving on to the next one, which is one that I already showed, which is right over there, and it is part of the Christmas tree scavenger hunt, I suppose. I didn't think that it was, but it is. Okay, so this one is the Mulan tree. This one's always been one of my favorites. Cool. Here's the Coca-Cola store, this is where we started our day today. Do you want to go and take Mulan off and stick her on there? We'll pretty much be halfway done, I think, at this point, once we do this one, right? We have six down, six to go or so.
This is very challenging with the wind.
It's a windy day today. There you go. It looks like the next one is going to be this one right over here. Okay, this is the first one that we saw when we arrived at Disney Springs, and this is of course going to be the Star Wars tree.
It's well, finally neat. Christmas, because Pentatonix is playing in Disney Springs.
Of course.
That's how it always feels like the season to me.
Alright, can you do it? Or do you need help this time?
Oh my god.
I have full confidence in you. And it looks like the next one's going to be right past Chicken Guy, it seems. Well, I'm glad that we came in over by the orange garage instead of the lime garage, right? Okay, bypassing Chicken Guy, even though it smells really good, to the next tree, which is right over here. So there are two Christmas trees in here. This one is, it looks like Minnie Mouse. So that means Mickey and Minnie Mouse.
So,
is there a Mickey and Minnie Mouse?
There is a Mickey and Minnie, and then there's also a Pluto.
Okay.
So, I mean, obviously, I'm more confident that this is the...
Yeah, this is definitely Mickey and Minnie, and Mickey it looks Minnie. Like there are two here. Okay, so there's Mickey and Minnie, and let's see who's on the other tree. Maybe it is Pluto. It doesn't look like it, though. Never mind, it totally is Pluto. Look at that big bone right there, and then a bunch of dog treats, and Pluto's collar, and then his doghouse way up there on top. Okay, so here's Pluto, right side up for the most parts. We just have a few more to do. We have to do this one, and then head all the way over to World of Disney. So, let's do it. So the next tree, I'm presuming, is the Christmas tree, and that's what this one is gonna be.
I didn't even consider it.
That's pretty cool. That makes a lot more sense, because it was just like, what theme is this? And it is the Christmas tree. Do you want to do the honors?
Okay, hold this.
Okay. And now we should head over to World of Disney, which really isn't that far away, comparatively, but the last one is going to be, what is that? Is that the Days of Christmas store, I wonder?
This
whatever
one,
it is, we can redeem our map. The very final one.
Yeah, so this just looks like it's outside
Lego
of
store,
World of Disney,
World
and
of
then
Disney.
This one is over by, like, Basin.
Okay. Ghirardelli, maybe?
We, of course, need to make it to the theme parks to fully enjoy the Christmas atmosphere there. But they have pretty much all the decorations here up and ready for appreciation at Disney Springs. I'm excited to go back to Magic Kingdom because I was there, but I had a mission, so I really didn't get to appreciate it, and I want to go back with Brennan.
Okay, there's the poutine booth. This is the back of the Lego store outside of World of Disney, which the new entrance is around the front. Oh, the new entrance, but this used to be the entrance, and I think I see the tree right over there. All right, and this one is Princess Tiana, or the Princess and the Frog.
I love the colors. I think I said
that last one. Yeah, it is a beautiful tree. You putting that sticker on there?
Yeah.
So by process of elimination,
the
last one should be Buzz and Woody, but let's go see. Oh, I wonder if it's outside of a Once Upon a Toy. Okay, this is the new entrance to World of Disney, which is the front, which makes the most sense. I don't see the final tree, so I guess it's not outside of Ghirardelli, which probably means over by Once Upon a Toy or the Marketplace Co-op. Brenda, do you remember when I used to work at Ghirardelli?
I did.
It's when we first started talking.
Yeah, and then the first time I met you, I think you smelled like waffle cones.
Mm-hmm. It's my special smell. It's how I got all the ladies back in the day. And here it is, the final tree, the Christmas Tree Stroll 2020. And it is indeed Toy Story. Okay, want to go ahead and do the honors of the final stamp?
Yeah, and then what do you think this is the redemption location?
It's probably the co-op.
Okay.
I'd imagine. I guess we'll find out. We'll probably have to ask around because we didn't know where to get the map, so we're not going to really know where to turn it in.
For my Andy shirt.
Yay!
Ta-da.
Oh yeah, wear your Andy shirt.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go get our prize.
Woo-hoo.
So that is actually not the place to redeem this. They told us it's over here in Photo Pass, but Brennan, you got something that's
gonna
be pretty cute.
I saw something and I felt super impulsive. And I never thought I was gonna be this person, but it turns out I am. I bought this little outfit.
This is for Arlo. Oh,
he's
no.
He's gonna be so handsome in his plaid shirt.
He's gonna have little Christmas jammies.
My God.
Okay, let's go redeem this before it starts to actually rain.
Okay.
So we probably should have noticed the sign right there that said we could redeem our map, but this is what we got. We got a Christmas tree stroll 2020 button. So that's cool, right?
Yeah.
Something they definitely did not have to do at all, but they
all
did.
All these discounts, right?
Yeah, they have a lot of discounts on the back.
So all offers valid November 6th through December 30th.
We'll have to come back and check some of these out, that's for sure.
So maybe you just bring this to the establishments. I don't know. We'll figure it out.
So to reward ourselves, or I guess for Brennan to reward herself, she's going to stop inside Ghirardelli and get a little treat. Okay, so Brenna, what did you end up getting from Ghirardelli?
So we're going to my parents tonight, so I just wanted to like give them a little treat to kick off the holidays. So I got them this, but then they had a 3 bags for $20 deal, so I got us one of these, and then just like a little peppermint bark one.
Yay!
They have a dark chocolate peppermint bark.
And we can also give them the various jams and honeys and sauces that you got from Southern Hill Farms.
Free chocolate in here.
What? So we are definitely going to be able to enjoy that with Brennan's parents. And then back home, of course. Now we're heading home to grab Arlo and then to go say hi to Brennan's parents because she hasn't seen them in a while. I think the scavenger hunts and how they implemented it in a social distance sort of a way was actually super unique. It made it a lot of fun. I do love the Christmas tree trail, but getting to actually do it as a scavenger hunt, even though we only got a button, which isn't the most elaborate of prizes, but because it is a completely free activity to do at
it's
Disney
not
Springs.
About the prizes.
No,
it's
it was
about
neat.
The discounts on the back. Just kidding.
And I think we're definitely gonna have to come back and just check out Disney Springs at night because it really is a different atmosphere, especially with all of the Christmas lights and getting to see those Christmas trees at night. They're gonna be cool. Alright, let's head out of here and go to your parents.
Alright, so we made it back to the parking garage. Thank you for hanging out with us today. I think we just barely beat the rain, so I'm feeling pretty confident about that. We got to enjoy a few drinks, a few snacks at Disney Springs. Brenna got to get herself a little some treats for herself and for her parents, and then a surprise for Arlo, and we're gonna see how he cooperates with that. We got to do the Christmas tree stroll around Disney Springs, and that was just a blast. And I don't know, I'm getting in that Christmas mood as far as Disney's concerned, and we gotta make it to the park soon so we can really, really enjoy it and take advantage of the season this year. But we'll see you soon. Have a good day, and goodbye.
Bye.